Hey guys, just another gamer here, and today we'll be doing on some exclusive summons reviews and at the same time some more summons. Alright, so let's kickstart and get into what's happening for this week. So okay, for this week, the net fives wise, okay, we have a Praha which is pretty good on the defense because there's a predicted future which actually removes all beneficials and then change them into dots. That's like around 90% when it's max. That's the rates. That's excluding the accuracy and also for the resistance. And then secondly, we have the Daydream, which actually heals all allies by 50% and putting herself to sleep. So if you have immunity, then you won't fall asleep. So that's like the rough idea to it. Then next up we have is Okeanos. Okay, Okeanos is more like an attacker because for the first kill we actually remove on the beneficial, one beneficial. Then the second attack we actually reset on the cooldown. Then for the first kill is transforming or weakening effects from you to an enemy. So that's like example, you have a defense break and then you pass it to somebody which you like to actually pass it to. So this is actually quite effective if you are dealing with like Baladions. I mean, supposedly actually Baladion or some other like Galleon were to just hit on Okeanos, so you just transfer that the armor break effects to other opponents which you want to take down on first. Then for last skill, okay, so basically what this skill is that it hits multiple times. Then right after that, for each other opponent that actually stun, you actually recover a 25% of your attack bar. So this actually makes you have like almost another instantaneous stun, provided you stun of course. Yep, and then you come with a leader accuracy of 41%, so I miss out on that one. Praha wise is a 41% resistance, which is pretty good for like almost everywhere, including like raids. Then next up we have is the Chimera. So Chimera wise, okay, so this Chimera is the win one, which has the leader skill for all allies for 50% HP, and then for the first skill is you'll put like a dot. Second skill is your damage will be increased with speed, and then if you actually get a critical hit, you actually get another speed boost. So this could actually make it a permanent. So if you don't crit, I think as much as possible, just make this guy like full crit because you do not want this one hit to actually go waste. And then you need to get the speed boost or else it's like defeating the purpose. And then last but not least, you have this lightning strike, which actually weakens the attack power for 2 turns, and this like 100% activation rate, so the rest will be based on accuracy and resistance once again. And then the second portion of this skill is that it may actually stun the opponent for 1 turn with a 50% chance. Alright, so for the net force that we have, for the fusion food deck will be Mikin. Then for the rest of the net force, we have Tyrone. So Tyrone has 2 CCs and this is pretty good for like TOA. I believe many of you guys could be using it already. And then if you actually place it for the like AD or like the guild defense, so arena defense or guild defense, it actually comes with a 19% speed lead for that is for general. So that's a pretty good and useful skill unless you already have like a Shimite which is 24%, or you have like a general speed lead of 24% or some other mobs. Then next up we have a travel. So travel wise, I'm not quite that used to like taking damage then you know to do damage. So currently it's still on vampire, so mine doesn't really perform that well. So if you're using this, try to avoid vampire. Yup, so that's like my take to this guy, because I mean it's good if like dealing with like Veramos kind of units. Oh, I got a defense victory. Okay. So if you're doing the like mobs like example like Veramos or like a Retesh, though maybe Trevor can actually excel way better, but I have my own counters in with regards to those. So if you're using that way, then yep, I would actually strongly advise on like making a Trevor. And if you have not used your HOH pieces, I think this is a good time whereby you can spam them. Then Jhin wise, I think we can just avoid Jhin for the time being because I don't quite find the damage and multiplier being that good. I have it as a 6 star, but I've not touched it ever since. And another thing is that my skill ups aren't fully maxed. So for the Wind Mermaid wise, it was previously on the HOH, so if you actually farm but do not build Wild the Mermaid, so you can just skip this. Or else, having my take on the mermaids wise, I think the fire will be like a better choice among the 3 elements, But then again, there's still the light and dark, which are like way more formidable as compared to the wind, water, and the fire. So to move on to the net trees. So the net trees wise, we have for fusion, which will be the water harpy, fire living armor, yes, and then the beast hunter, and then I think the wind inferno. Someone checked that for me. Right, then we'll move on to the next week. So next week we have is anvil. So anvil wise, probably I might do more PvP videos for this week because I will click on the trial ascension for both cases. So probably I'll showcase more on the anvil for this week. Then next up we have is the Fire Monkey King, which is immune to stunt. If you do not know that, he's immune to stunt, including like freeze, sleep, everything, because inability effects. I believe sleep is also inclusive. Maybe I could just find one in the arena and try to make it sleep. So it actually increases on his stacks up to 10 times, and that's like 200% attack boost when it's max, because 20% times 10. Then has a general lead for 33% for defense, which is also good for the raids. Then for the first skill, actually a healing agent, because you actually heal like a shot of like 15%. Whereas the wind monkey actually increases his bar by 50%. So, and then the first skill also stuns, just like all the other monkey kings. Then next up we have will be Edna. So Edna wise, I seen one which is quite good, which is like super speedy, because shatter only costs like 2 turns when it's max. So you can just keep shattering mobs or the enemies, and then you just spam on the capture. So this way your capture actually usually will hit on the defense break monster. So that's like a quite a good way in order to deal with this. Comes with arena lead, which is, I believe this will be the same as Camilla, which is 33% critical rate for arena. Yep, that could be actually quite useful if you're using like a beast monk in your defense. But then if you're using the beast monk which is tuned for kill mask in like the guild battles, then you're using you're also putting a beast monk in your defense, so that 33% could be useful. So next up for the net force, we have for the fusion, that would be the fire succubus. Yep, had enough of all this fusion at last. And then the efforts actually paid off for the trial ascension. So okay, for Stella wise, a friend of mine did on the 6 star for all these 4 raids, but other than the HP wise, that and the skill up which isn't max, so I can't really say if this is actually useful, because this comes with branding, and then the third skill decreases on the attack bar. So what his plan is, that he's using this like a Hua with Kanji the branding. So but then 6 turns for this skill is way too ridiculous if you do not have it skilled up. So that's like my take on it. Then the branding for 4 turns for over 2 turns, which don't really quite matter, because the boss will slow you down, and then everything else it might just go to waste. So for the first skill wise, which I don't quite find this really making me to make one of the assassins, because I already have like 2 of these 5 water assassins, none of the wind and none of the fire. So okay, then for the first skill, that this decrease the enemy's defense, but its max is like 75%, which doesn't really make quite much sense, especially when this guy's an attacker, and then you want to put in the branding and the defense break. So in all case, I think could go for Helia, the dark harpy. So that's like my take to it. Then Lisa wise, okay, Lisa, I'm using this for Neko, which is for like speed attack and attack, because I do not want her to actually cleanse then the boss and then do on the attack command against me, which makes no sense, because attack command also reduces 1 turn cooldown for all the skills, which example 3 turns from the mind control from the boss will make it 2 turns, and then if the boss still moves, then that's 1 turn, and then the boss doesn't have any slow, so could probably just steal 2 of your units. So actually kept on its attack by having it speed attack. Then next up we have the Wind Kung Fu Girl, which I think we'll skip this for now, and then Akila, which is like a Sikh, which has this crit rate attack power buff, and then the third skill, which is a remove of beneficial effects. I'm not sure if I'm going to make this, but I don't have any idea who I'm going to pair this with, so I will put this on hold still. Maybe I'll just build it like a speed HP just for the buff removal, maybe not. That's like my take to it. Increases on attack power, so I'm not sure if I'm really actually going to build this. I had one recently, alright. So we move on to the next three was for the fusion food rehash, which will be the water griffon, then the fire high elemental, and then the wind harpy. And not to forget that we have a penguin knight here. If you are using this for trial ascension, you could try this out, but so far I have not tried this out because I'm still short of one rune for my case, so I can't really say if this guy is actually good or this guy is actually bad. So then, oh my god, I actually seen, I saw Vanessa. Okay, this is Vanessa there. Okay, I scrolled down by accident, sorry about that. So for the net 5 for 2 weeks time, we have this Aerial, which could be very good for the, if you're using this for like Nemesis and then you build this for like raids, which is like around 30 over K kind of HP and then maybe like 1k 2k kind of defense, this could be actually be potentially good for your defense on Nemesis, because this can be used for, it's quite pretty good for store, and then at the same time we have a like 50% increase of HP that is also for himself, which is also a good thing. Then next up we have Rakan, so another unit which has 50% boost of HP for its own element. Then Rakan wise, okay, so it actually something close to like Zeratul's kind of that second skill. So basically what this is that you actually increase on attack power and immunity, so that actually counts as a turn and you gain another turn immediately, which then is to say that you actually like remove on like a defense break, which is 2 turns. Then next of all, you move off to Collapse, which is a damage, a skill, his last skill, which is based on his HP. So if you're actually building this, maybe HP, critical damage HP, I'm not sure about this, because your can is still like being mixed up, whereby first attack skill is still skilled by his attack, but then the third skill is actually based on his HP, so it's like a little bit mixed. Then Retesh, I'm still trying to build up my Retesh to building it up further. So currently mine is like on the HP, critical rate HP, so in order to get like a max critical rate. So Retesh wise, this will heal, whereby if his HP is below 50%, he'll heal himself by 40% of his max HP. And then if his HP is above 50%, he may actually heal the alive of the lowest HP ratio by 40%. So the third skill is that he will actually do a mass defense breaks, so that's all. And then for all the beast monks, if you actually get a critical hit, you will get a speed buff, so that's why you want to maximize on your critical rate, which then in conjunction is also back to your third skill, which also deals more damage when it's on critical rate. Then we move on to the net force wise. Okay, the net force for the fusion, that will be Beretta. Then we have a leech, which can be good for rates, because it should be, because it can be also be good for Necro, because the water and the wind leech, both of them, their kits are like rather useful for Necro, which might consider and might not consider, so I do not know like when I'm gonna try this on. Then we'll move on is chilling. So okay, chilling, that's is like the one of time that you guys have it for the exclusive summons. I believe this will be like the first time. Then next off we'll move off is the Alfoy. So the Alpha has the lightning drop, which actually slows the enemy with it crits. That's only if you actually awaken it. So for the second skill is a reset of the cooldown, then the third skill is that removing on harmful effects, and at the same time healing of your allies by 20% and also granting immunity. So that's quite a good cleanser if you're using this for raids. I'm also using this for raids. Maybe I could make some raid videos over this week. So that's just like some considerations. And then 2 weeks time, I'm not sure if by then that will be like time for the Hall of Heroes, but then again, Brienne seems to be coming in like during the free removal and also at the same time whereby it's near the Hall of Heroes, because I think that this unit is still rather useful in terms of using for the Hall of Heroes. Alright, so for the next trees that we have for 2 weeks time, that for the fusion, that will be the Water Bear Man. Then could it be so little people? Oh yeah, the Fire Serpent, which is also for Beretta, and then the Wind Lizard Man, which I can't remember who is this. I think it's Argon, the Wind Vampire. So in 2 weeks time, alright, this set of lists is actually pretty nice in my opinion, because we have Varet, which is very good for TOA because of 2 CCs, and then one, this is the one that frees. So then the second one is that the one that actually reduces the bar to 0. So You could build this like despair or even violent, and then at the same time you have a leader skill of 33% HP, which could be like a good sub until you get like a proper lead for the raids. So because at the same time your this second skill actually based on defense, so if you actually build this like a front line for your raids, that could actually work out also, because definitely you need some guy which is on like some HP and also of defense. We'll talk more about those in like the raids when I do a raid video. That is, so the next up we have Vanessa, which I have read some, I think like around 6 weeks ago, I guess. Can't remember exactly how long. So the first skill, if it actually kills an enemy, it will proc the second skill, which is based on the enemy's HP and puts in a defense break. And then the third skill is a warrior's return, which is a heal. I mean a revive, which comes with a heal buff that is 15% for next 2 turns of a heal. So the guy unit is like pretty fast, or you could actually speed the guy up, then you actually could get like a full turn already. So that will also mean that you get like a 45% HP kind of recovery or heal. Alright, so next off, last of all for the net fights, we have a Triton. So Triton is like, Triton, I feel that this is like a good unit in terms of like removing the buffs, and at the same time you decrease on the attack bar. So it's unlike what this, of course you can't beat Tiana with this, but then again you actually remove on the beneficial effects, which is what you need. And then Tiana wise, you actually gain on the attack bar. So for this guy wise, he actually reduces the bar, so it at the same time could like potentially gain something close to what this Tiana does. And I believe that this base speed is like higher than Tiana, correct me if I'm wrong, maybe it's like near thereabout. Then here's a general lead skill for 33% defense, and then the second skill is already another AoE, which then makes you feel like putting him on despair or even on swift, because you need this guy to move first, of course. Then same for the first skill, yep, he'll transfer the weakening effects. Okay, last of all we have for the net force for the fusion, which will be ninja, the water ninja, which will be for, what's that guy's called, I think Sigmarus, you need a ninja. Then for the other net force, we have his Chloe, which I don't need to go through about this. Then water Taurus wise, I think it's quite decent, because this skill whereby it has 2 chances to actually slow the enemy, so you get 2 hits. So if the enemy is really slowed, you could actually stun the enemy with this hit on the next hit to say. Then for this, the multiplier for this skill is like rather high, like around 170%. So when this guy is max, it's like around 185% times 4. So you could actually harm the enemy quite pretty hard. So I might actually plan on building one of these. It's like already 5 star max at the moment. So I just need like Taui's food, or else honestly, I don't even want to build this, because I don't like handicap match. If you want to use it, you use it to like the full potential of like the max of the skills. Because if you do not actually max a skill, then that this very unit is like quite subpar as compared to like other units that you may actually have. So alright, I think somebody, one of you guys, one of the subscribers is like aiming for the Hua and the Chloe, I think something like that, or like the second Chloe. Yep, so I think this could be your turn to actually get the Rakshasa, the Hua again. Then for Julian wise, I think we've gone through this like quite recently. So this guy is like a stun machine, first skill stun, second skill stun, and third skill also stun. So I won't touch much about it, but probably when we're actually closer to the weeks, then we might actually touch on it. Then for the net trees wise, for the fusion, we have is the water magical archer, fire serpent once again, and then the wind amazon. Yep, so that actually pretty much sums up all for the these exclusive summons. So I actually did on the exclusive summons like before this was actually being rotated, which is like around 2 hours ago, which I did this. So in my opinion, I felt that the previous one was pretty good, because it had the Singzer and the Perna, and then the Galleon, which I also need, which haven't got any of it. As you can see that, I mean like once again on the renting again, because where is it? The yup, I still have like 700 pieces of this. And then the mermaid wise, yup, I do not really quite find it like a need to build the mermaids. So in my opinion, if you're actually going for like in terms of like defense, then you could either go for like Ritesh, Vanessa, Triton, or else this week could go for Overker, the Praha. Then for offense units, I think, I mean offense units is like everybody can be used for offense for most cases. Unlike if you're TOA specific, then there will be like Varet, the Water Dragon. And then I think that's like the only unit that is for like the TOA. Yup, and then if 4 rates, then Praha, yes, then the Fire Monkey King could be also be useful as a DPS for the rates. And then I'm using a level for my rates. Then area for rates is also legit. And yep, I think I guess I've gone through all of the segments of like the areas that I need to cover on. So I'll be right back for a little bit, then I will do on the summons. So be right back. Hey guys, just another gamer here, and I'm actually doing on the summoning stones like before the cycle changes, because overall I feel that there's more that I want from this cycle as compared to the next few cycles, because all the netfalls for the next few cycles pretty much that is either that I have, other than maybe like Tyrone, which I haven't had one. Then other than that, more or less I actually have like what I do want to have. So, and of course there is the monkey and the phoenix, which everybody's dream to have one of them, except for maybe for Beth, can I say it that way? So I think that I have like 10 tries, so I think let's just like pop all 10 tries in, then we'll see like how many mystical schools I'm going to throw in for later. So without much further ado, let's throw in some of this, because the other time that I actually did, oh my god, are you serious? There goes the luck. So the other time I actually did on this summoning stones, then everything was like I didn't really quite get anything that I want, because all of them are like the net trees. I mean, there isn't any lightning from the like 19 or 20 schools, I think, can't remember it. So not sure what we are gonna get today, and then that's like really like 4 tries. This like the 5th try. And all of them are like Frankensteins, which is crazy. Okay, we left 4 tries. Just one for a Galleon. Just one Galleon would do. Maybe not today. Nope, don't think it's for today. Yup. So that's like almost like 30 tries back, right? There isn't much of lightning. So right, I'll see you guys later for when the exclusive has been reset. Yup, see you guys in a bit. Alright, so now I'm back, and obviously I don't have like stones for the exclusive because I spammed it on the previous one, which you just saw it earlier in this part of the video. I mean, like just right before this. So I think we will only, nope, not the legendary nor the light and darkness, because I think I'll pop them like next week after we get the light and dark piece, I mean the scroll, which is like in a few days time. Today's like 22nd, so in like around 36 hours time, if you actually lock in. I mean, from 36 hours time onwards, I'll be able to get on the light and darkness scroll. So as for today wise, I don't know how many scrolls I'm going to pop, because I only popped like 10 earlier with the exclusive, then I have like around 16 now left for mystical scrolls. So I guess we'll just see what we are able to get, which I do not know what we are able to get. Okay, samurai. So that's like, okay, another cast, which formerly was from the Hall of Heroes. So let's see how many lightning we get from like 10 scrolls, then we will see if like I'm going to do like another hype, if I'm like going to finish them all, because end of the day I only have like a few. I actually went to see like my monster list, and then there's like only a few units that I haven't gotten at all. Example like Kaito, I've not got it. Then okay, that's the wing, the Water Green Ripple, which is like from the SD over the weekend. So I started with 16, so let's go with like 2 more and see if like, but you guys know the end of the day I'll like spam all the scores. Yup, I'm gonna like spam them all off, because there's like really not many stuff that I might actually need or want. But then again, that all these are like taking up my spaces, which then I think I need to like do on like more of the summon, like more of the dragons one to get all the rainbow mons. Ah crap. Yep, nothing much except for the water samurai for today, but that doesn't really matter, because really honestly, because really I do not have like much of the units that I would actually need. I think I'll just show you guys at the same time. Oh yeah, I think today we'll like stray off away from like what we always do. I mean, unlike what you always do. So you can see that I'm only short of like 4 units for the 5 units. So that's like only a Verde Hill, Karak, then Lexi and Smokey. Then we'll move on to the water units. Okay, yep. So this is like Tyrone, Lumi, then the Kung Fu Girl, Malaka, Aegil, which is the water barbaric king. Then Galleon, the mermaid. Can't remember the name. Then Emma, then this water Anubis, and then water Horus. So actually like the whole thing I'm aiming now is like maybe for like net 5s, or else it's like specific net 4s, which you see how many there is like already left for me, and then compare it on the other way whereby it's like I only have like a few specifics that I need to get or I might actually want. So that's why I'm really not that really disappointed if like all these summons, just telling you guys, because in case like people saying like, oh, you got too little lightnings over the past few weeks, etc. So I'm not actually that sad about this. Alright, so let's get back to the summoning hitch. So let's have a look at the exclusive summons just to guide you guys more. So for the current week, I think that if you're aiming for like Oracle, of course you can go for that. Then for Net Force, I think the Sylph, Water Sylph, Tyrone, Travel, this could be of good use, so you have like around 3 units. Then for next week's time, the Net Force don't really quite seem that really appetizing or tempting for me even. So then maybe in 2 weeks time you guys could just save for like chilling. And then Brienne, if you have not gotten yours, therefore it could be also useful. Leech wise, I think could probably hold on, or else if you haven't got a Chloe, then definitely go for Chloe or Hua. Then of course the net fives wise is all pretty good for the 3 weeks time. So then we will stop right here for today. Then I'll see you guys in the next video, which is I think it's tomorrow. So in all the case, if you are only just watching for the summons, then that'll be I'll see you guys for next week. So good luck for you guys in summoning, and then I'll see you guys. Thanks for watching and goodbye.